Hello, my name is Freddy Hurkmans. Today I will explain how files work in C. In contrary to my previous films, this will not be useful for C++. In C++, you will normally handle files in an object-oriented approach, which obviously doesn't apply for C. This film, therefore, is only suitable for C. If you want to work efficiently with files, it's a good idea to better understand what a file is. You can visualize a file as just a very long array of bytes. Something like this. The data in that array can be interpreted in different ways, as binary data or as text. In both cases, it's just data. It's the interpretation you use that gives it meaning. A binary file is quite similar to memory, as in the way you put data into the file has the exact same layout as that data in memory. In a text file, you write ASCII characters. That is, by default. You could of course also work with Unicode files. It's just that C, by default, uses ASCII characters. There are obviously a lot of differences between binary files and text files. One of the differences is that binary files are easier to work with. I already mentioned the similarity with memory. I'll let you figure out what makes binary easier. A big disadvantage of binary data is that it's less portable. I'll again let you figure out why. It's important to realize that Linux doesn't really distinguish between binary files and text files. In other words, a text file is just a file, filled with ASCII characters. A binary file is also just a file, filled with characters. It's just that those characters are interpreted in another way. In Windows, you must explicitly tell the system whether you are opening a text file or a binary file. Later on, I'll mention what to do in Windows. What can I do with files? To show you what you could do with files, I will number the bytes I've drawn. What you could do with files is simply reading or writing. To do this, you must first open the file. You must tell the operating system that you want to read or write the file. When you've opened the file, the system will keep a file index. This file index is a bookmark to where you are in the file. After opening the file in normal read or write mode, this file index is always zero. In other words, you could say the file index points to this byte in the file. Then you can read or write data. Let's assume I write the text hello into my file. After writing this text, the file index will now be 5. When I am done writing, I must close the file. Closing the file releases the system resource and ensures all caches are flushed, which makes sure all data is now really on disk. Another thing I could do with a file is reading or writing on a certain position. Imagine having a file filled with structures such as this one. The file contains elements, each of which has an integer and an array of 8 characters. On a 32-bit system, the structure will be 12 bytes big. In other words, here I will read element 0 and here I will read element 1. Let's say I want to read this element. First, I again need to open the file for reading. After opening, my file index will be 0. So the second step is to seek to the correct position in my file. I must make sure the file index points here. I do that by seeking to an offset of 1 time the size of this structure. The third step is to actually read 12 bytes of data. In other words, read these bytes, and after that I can again close my file. When you work with fixed size data elements in a file, it is sometimes an advantage to know how many elements you have available. To compute the number of elements, you must obviously first open the file, which again makes the file index 0. Then you must seek to the file end. You can seek in 3 ways, relative to the file start, relative to your current position, or relative to the file's end. If you seek to 0 bytes relative to your file's end, you are at the end of the file. Let's say the file index is now 120. When I read the file index, I will obviously get 120, which tells me I have 120 bytes of data in my file. If I divide this number by the size of my structure, 12 in this case, I will get the number of elements in my file. Now I can do useful stuff with these 10 elements, and when I'm done, I can again close the file. A last thing for now, that can come in handy in certain test situations, is creating a large file, for instance, a 1 gigabyte file. As far as I am aware, this trick only works in Unix systems such as Linux. What you need to do is open the file for writing, your file index is now 0. Then you seek to the offset corresponding to the required file size. So when you need a file of 1200 bytes, you seek to 1200. And on that spot, you write 1 byte and then close the file. This example obviously gives you a file of 1201 bytes. So if you really needed an exact 1200 bytes, you'd have to seek to position 1199. Which functions do you need to work with files in C? In the PRC courses, you need to be able to work with 6 functions. File open, to open a file. File close, to close it again. File read, to read from your file. File write, to write to your file. File tell, to read the current file index. And file seek, to go to a certain position in the file. How do these functions work? In Linux and other Unix systems, this information is available in manual pages. You get these manual pages by entering the following command on the command line. Man fopen. That is, if you want information about fopen. The 3 you see in between man and fopen tells the manual system in which section you want to search. As you can see here, section 3 contains all C functions. So if you don't want to get confused, it's a good idea to type man space 3 space and then your command. This is what the fopen man page looks like. It shows which include you need and what the function looks like. In this case, the return type is pointer to a file struct and the parameters, a file name that includes a full or relative path, and the opening mode. Mode can be R for read, W for write, or other options like R+, W+, etc. Important for Windows users, if you want to open your file as binary, you must add a B to the R or W. For instance, RB for reading and WB for writing, and RB+, etc. Linux will simply ignore the B, so this is not a problem when you want to write code for multiple platforms. If you only program for Linux, you can ignore the B. These man pages are great to have, as they are almost always installed, as far as I know, always on desktop Linux systems, sometimes on servers, and usually not on embedded systems, and they contain a ton of useful information about lots of stuff. For C functions, they mention how you can use the function, what the return type is, in which context you can safely use the function, etc. So make sure you get familiar with these pages and let them help you.